Testing, testing. One, two.
Money in the slot, and I came up a loser. You and he, Judy and Cherie, are raking in a sizable amount. I put my money on the line, and I drew a big number. Pass it around. Won't you pass it around? Won't you pass it around? Take what you need, put the rest down. Take what you need, put the rest down. Take what you need.
I'm having a good time. Now, would you please all feed the kitty? Kitty feeds me. Y'all know Bill Bailey? All right. Mrs. Bailey asked us all to sing. Boom, boom, boom. In that rainy evening, she threw you out with 95 fine tooth comb. She's too vain now. Ain't that a shame?
Okay, show's over. Let's go. Everybody move along. Come on.
Sorry, folks. Let's break it up. Come on,
Will.
Come on.
Can't you guys leave me alone?
Come on, Will. Don't give us a hard time.
Move it out.
Move it out.
You guys can't do this.
Keys are in the truck.
You don't have to go, folks. The judge said I could play.
With nothing but a fine tooth comb. I know what to do now.
Thank you. Thank you very much.
Bill Bailey.
Wasson?
Yep.
Your lawyer's come to get you. Hey, what are you supposed to be?
Actually, I'm a Yankee Doodle Dandy. A Yankee Doodle Do or Die. A real live nephew of my Uncle Sam.
Hell, Miss Ash, we're not trying to cause problems. But we can't have every damn buddy parking their trucks in the plaza, playing the damn piano. Either he's blocking the sidewalk or he's blocking the street.
Chief, my client is protected by the First Amendment. That covers freedom of speech and assembly. And the court order says that as long as this case is in the appeals, you are not allowed to harass him. I don't know. This looks an awful lot like contempt of court to me. What's that?
His rap sheet. I ran a complete make on him.
That's not his name.
But it's his fingerprints. I thought you'd be interested.
Is something the matter?
I just can't believe they had the nerve to take you in again.
No big deal.
Listen, it's an insult to me. If you'd have been Alfred's client or Manny's, they wouldn't dare touch you.
Did you see your car anywhere?
No, it's not a car. It's a truck with the piano in the back. Drums.
Where's my truck?
Where's his truck?
Maybe we better go back inside for a minute.
What'd you guys do with my truck?
Look, don't blame me. This is a really lousy neighborhood.
Neighborhood? This is a police station. His truck was stolen from a police station.
No, 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 no,
no, no, no, no, no, no, no, no, no, no, no.
Ow! Stop! Ah! Oh, they're fighting.
Now, stop. I can't.
Who's William, little horse?
Why'd you change your name to Thorson?
I was tired of going to the movies and rooting for the losers.
You might also have mentioned that you were in prison.
I'd have mentioned it eventually.
What'd you have in mind, a deathbed confession?
Oh, I mean, it's no big deal. Just Alcatraz.
You were in Alcatraz?
No, it wasn't in Alcatraz. You know the big Indian land right demonstrations? We occupied Alcatraz.
I was sent to Leavenworth.
That's for the assault with a deadly weapon charge?
No. That was later, when I was at Stanford Law.
You went to Stanford Law?
But I didn't graduate. I'm going to go finish making the popcorn.
Wait a minute. Wait a minute. Let me get this straight. They let you into law school after you were in prison?
Yeah, I was an Indian ex-convict. The Minority Admissions Committee was thrilled.
Well, what's this about an assault charge?
Well, they didn't have a Native American Studies program. Eventually, we had to hold the dean hostage.
You held the dean at gunpoint just to get a course about Indians?
Well, actually, it was a bow and arrow. It was supposed to be symbolic. You want to melt some butter for me?
Well, I knew you were a little offbeat. Didn't realize you were completely out of your mind.
William Little Horse was out of his mind. Will Thorson was just out of a job. Until he gets another truck and clean up. Putting on a little weight, aren't you?
Oh, go to hell.
What, are you angry?
Yes, I'm angry. I'm sleeping with a man for 6 months. I don't even know his name.
Well, my father's name was Thorson. He was a Scandinavian. My mother's name was Little Horse. She was a Zuni Indian. I should have told you. Okay. Sorry. See, I used to want to change the world. Until I found out that it wasn't such an easy thing to do. Now I just want to be left alone to play my music and have a good time. You want to know about William Little Horse? As far as I'm concerned, he's some guy I used to know in California. He used to get in trouble a lot. We don't keep in touch much anymore.
I'm sorry. I'm sorry I got angry.
Personally, I'm glad you got angry. If you hadn't gotten angry, you wouldn't have taken my case. If you hadn't taken my case, I wouldn't have just had my wigwam.
You're so romantic.
It's the Indian blood.
What do you mean I'm putting on a little weight?
Sorry.
I'm the one that got your ass out of a sling, and don't you forget it.
Well, popcorn's ready. Want to go back in the bedroom?
Bring the salt.
I'm not even going to bring the popcorn.
You know how tight money is today?
Mrs. Padilla, if I can't buy a new truck and a new piano, I'm going to starve to death, and the police are eventually going to have to reimburse a very skinny dead person.
But you don't have a co-signer, and you don't have any credit references.
Well, you mean if I were in debt already, you'd be happy to lend me more, but since I've never needed to borrow, you can't? Somebody in there, somebody a little higher up might be more free to take a chance, right?
Well, you have a lot to learn about banks. You don't get to be higher up by taking chances.
Please.
All right, just a minute.
Thank you.
Hi,
I'm the guy she's talking
about. Toombs, this is Mr. Thorson, present at the bank.
Pleasure to meet you.
Mr. Thorson, Mrs. Padilla has explained your request to me. I'm afraid I'm terribly late for an appointment.
I'll be glad
to
wait.
I won't be back for the rest of the afternoon.
How about tomorrow?
Well, you could come by. I'm not sure if I can squeeze you in or not. It's been nice meeting you.
I'm sorry.
I'd really like to close my account here. I wish I had one.
An ulcer, right? That's what you thought it was.
You'd be glad it's not an ulcer. You would hate an ulcer. You had special diet and all that Maalox.
You don't have to play games with me, Martha. What's wrong with me?
I've known you a long time. I just don't know how you're going to take this. Medical term for what is wrong with you is morning sickness.
Oh, God. I can't be pregnant. Martha, you told me I couldn't get pregnant. Are you joking?
Well, if I am, you get the punchline in about 6 months.
I can't have a baby, Martha. I can't. Not now.
Well, I didn't think that you would be overjoyed. I have a little set speech that I give to women who react the way you did. If you at all want to consider an abortion, you should make the decision soon. It would still be pretty simple. A D&C. I want you in the hospital the night before for a complete workup. You have the procedure in the morning, and you're home that night.
When?
You could check in Friday, tomorrow. After work. Something wrong?
Dumb. I was going to wax my floors this weekend.
Shiny floors can wait. Now, this can't. I figure you're about 10 weeks gone. In a week or so, the procedure becomes more difficult.
I have to think about it, Martha.
You plan to marry him?
I don't know. I never thought about it. He's so damn immature. I shouldn't marry him. I should send him to summer camp.
Amy, not too long, okay?
Yeah, I know. Amy, you're late. Mr. Venable's waiting for you in his office. And the lawyers from the Garcia firm called about your deposition. Are you all right? Well, the demur's going to be on Tuesday. I'm sorry I'm late. John Michael.
Hello, Amy.
John Michael has a problem. Please, sit down.
Actually, I'm getting rid of a problem. Janice and I are splitting up.
Boy, you just don't seem cut out for marriage, do you?
Well, you came out of it okay.
I'm sorry. I don't mean to be bitchy. I'll be available when you're through with John Michael.
I want you to handle it. I want you to handle my divorce.
I understood you the first time. I just didn't believe you. You want to hire your first wife to get rid of your second.
Well, it makes sense to me. I like our divorce. I want another one just like it. Sane and sensible and relatively painless.
For you, maybe.
I'm not asking for a happy ending, just one without hysterics. You handled yourself so well, I'm hoping you can convince Janice to do the same.
I explain. This is very irregular.
Irregular? Please, this is outrageous. Do you remember our divorce? 6 hours after the final decree, he was calling me up and asking me out. He came to my graduation. He stops by my office every time he comes to see you. He even invited me to his wedding. I'm just amazed you didn't want me along on the honeymoon.
I didn't realize you felt so strongly.
John Michael, why couldn't you have been that attentive when we were married? I don't want to have anything to do with this.
I always thought you lawyers prided yourselves on being hired guns.
I've gone through one divorce with you, John Michael. Isn't that enough?
I think she'll come around.
No. From the table.
Hey, we got 10 bucks.
Give me a bit. Any difference to me whether it's from the table or not?
Whatever you guys want me to do it, I'll be glad to do it.
Hey, man, it's your money.
All right. Ready?
Ready?
Go!
You know, this could be the easiest 10 bucks we ever made.
We got ourselves a turkey.
You got that right. I haven't seen one like this in a long time.
10 seconds.
Come on, man.
15 seconds. Slow yourself down, Turkey. You gotta pace yourself.
Yeah, he looks like a turkey.
20 seconds. We got a long way to go.
Come on, come on. Faster.
Don't get sick, boy.
You got a burp? You're still not gonna make it.
30 seconds.
Street bastard.
Make him laugh. It'll squirt out his nose.
I think he's gonna puke. Who taught you how to drink? Come on, come on.
40 seconds.
$10 ready, don't you?
Drink up. It's gonna take all money.
Drink. No, you ain't gonna take
45.
Drink.
Take our money. Three.
No. God damn it.
No.
He suckered us.
Yeah, he suckered us. That was a downright religious experience.
You still want that pizza?
Yeah, sure.
It's on the house.
Thanks a lot.
I'll be seeing you turkeys at Thanksgiving. I always had trouble picturing you with this car.
It belonged to my ex-husband. He knew how much I liked it, so he gave it to me when I graduated from law school. And I stopped taking alimony.
Beats the hell out of a dictionary.
It was always like that, you know? The grand gesture. That's good. I like that.
Thank you.
I saw him today. My ex.
Is that what you wanted to talk about?
No. It'll wait. We'll go someplace quiet afterwards, okay?
Let's skip the reception. Right?
I have to make an appearance, but we won't stay long. Attention to him, we're just keeping him until the radio's fixed.
Somebody at the bar, I just assumed Boyd. Young guy over there, street musician, plays in the plaza, you've probably seen him before. I wonder who invited him anyway. He came into the bank today, wants a loan.
And you won't give it to him?
Get serious, Amy, the kid's a flake. Well, come on, if it was your money, you wouldn't want me lending it to someone like him, would you?
You keep forgetting I don't bank with you anymore.
What'd I say?
You heard about the new restaurant on the moon? Great food, but no atmosphere.
Alfred, would you excuse us for a moment?
Is something wrong?
Well, I was just thinking about our conversation this afternoon. About John Michael's request. You know, it doesn't even seem like the kind of thing that you'd bring up.
No?
Unless there was something else involved. Like a threat from my ex-husband to pull all the bank business from the firm if he didn't get his way. See, I know how John Michael thinks.
I don't want you to feel pressured.
Why should I? I'm not a partner. I mean, it's a lot of money, but none of it goes into my pocket. Now, if I was a partner, I'd have a bigger stake in keeping John Michael happy.
And I was worried about using pressure.
Well, I'm not being unreasonable, am I? I mean, I've been an associate for 4 years now.
Let's put it this way. Securing your ex-husband's divorce for him would show a devotion to the firm, which I and the other partners would hardly ignore.
You're an old sweetie. But you talk like a lawyer.
Yeah, whales.
Do you know what they make out of whale meat?
No, I don't.
Face cream! Face cream, perfume, and dog food. You are eliminating, you're exterminating an entire species, a thinking, feeling, awesome species to make dog food. You and the damn Russians. And you got to stop it. Now, I'm part Indian, all right? Maybe I don't look it, but I am. And I know all about extermination, and that's what it is. Systematic, wholesale extermination, and you got to stop it.
We have nothing to do with the whaling industry.
All right, but it's still your country, damn it!
We make digital watches.
Will, excuse me, I think we better go home now.
Look, you gotta take the word back, all right? It's up to us to stop the
car. Will!
If we don't do it, nobody else will!
Please go and get the car. Mr. Yamashiro, I'm terribly sorry. My friend was very rude. I apologize.
Please don't concern yourself.
Mr. Yamashiro! Remember Moby Dick!
Little horse rides again, huh?
Not funny, Will.
I know, that was important to me. I really care about whales.
Can't just go around shouting at people.
Well, I think if you believe in something, you'd raise your voice.
I agree. In the right place at the right time. Look, I'm glad you care about whales. I care about whales. If I had a swimming pool, I'd adopt one. What about jobs? What about work for some of your unemployed Indian buddies? Those two men you just insulted tonight represent about 400 jobs.
You want to just settle it?
Oh, come God, here. Will, you're such a goddamn child sometimes.
Well, that really bothers you, doesn't it?
You know, tonight was important to me, too. I negotiated a partnership.
No, I'm not talking about tonight. I'm talking about us, the age thing, the fact that you're older than I am. That really bothers you, doesn't it?
The age thing? I'm not that much older.
3 years.
Oh, fine. Well, let's wheel me into a rest home.
Wait. Are you telling me that it doesn't bother you?
It doesn't bother me.
3 years?
Would you stop saying 3 years? Anyway, it's not. It's 2 years and 9 months. And it doesn't bother me that I'm older. What bothers me is that you're so much younger.
Oh, okay.
Will, there's a difference.
Fine, and I'm so much younger.
There's a difference. Do you understand the difference? Look, Will, you're fun. You have an imaginative, creative mind, and you make me laugh. But you can't sing on street corners for the rest of your life. I mean, eventually, you're going to have to come back into the real world.
Oh, no thanks. It's a nice place to visit. I wouldn't want to live there.
Damn it, Will, I'm serious.
Well, what do you want from me? You want me to get a job? Is that it?
I want is for you to grow up.
Grow up?
You have a little thought of what you're doing, where your life is going. Don't you ever think about tomorrow?
Hey, I'm still trying to figure out what the hell I did wrong today. Amy, come on, will you relax?
No! Because tomorrow, where it's all going to wind up, Will, whether you like it or not. Maybe one of these days you'll see that. I think I'm going home.
Wait, Amy! Wait a minute. Are you going home for tonight or are you going home for good? Is this the big important thing that you wanted to talk to me about?
More or less. I just had to make a decision and tonight made it a little easier, that's all.
Quitting as my lawyer, too?
And miss a chance at arguing before the Supreme Court. Not on your life.
Amy. Amy.
I probably love you.
I see you got Captain Ahab off to bed. I wasn't sure you were coming home tonight.
He's a client.
So am I. Alfred says you're going to take my case.
Don Michael, I can't talk tonight.
You've been crying.
It's an allergy.
You were always a terrible liar.
You, on the other hand, were pretty good at it.
Good? I was wonderful. Half the time I convinced myself and then be furious when you didn't believe me. Amy. Want to tell me what you were crying about?
I want to go to bed. Don't say it.
I could stay with you just to make you feel better. I wouldn't try anything.
I thought you said you were a wonderful liar. John Michael, just go home, huh? We can talk about your divorce tomorrow.
Oh, wait a minute. I have something to cheer you up. To celebrate our new relationship. A ginkgo biloba.
Oh, John Michael, I know how you feel about your bonsai. I can't take one.
It's only about 50 years old. Hardly more than a corsage. You wouldn't turn down a corsage, would you? Consider it a retainer. I'm glad you changed your mind. I'll call you in the morning.
Yeah. Thanks, Trudy. Martha? I've decided to go ahead with the abortion. Now, what time do you want me at the hospital? Okay. I'll be there. And Martha, thanks. No, I mean it. Okay, see you tonight.
You can't come in. I'm Janice Toombs. John Michael said you were handling the divorce. I have to speak to you.
Mrs. Toombs, I can't talk to you.
Oh, damn it, woman. Would you just listen to me? You don't have to say anything. I just want you to listen. Well, living with John Michael certainly does teach you to assert yourself, doesn't it? It's the only way to make him hear what you're saying. You know, he adores you. He always has.
It's not quite the way I remember it.
Since the divorce. He's always kidding, you know, about how the marriage didn't take, but the divorce was a complete success. I've heard him tell the story, you know, about how all you would take in the divorce settlement was tuition so that you could go on and support yourself. He thought that was real classy. In a funny kind of way, all I'm asking for is the same thing. Only he doesn't see it that way. You know, you are the lucky one. You're smart. All I am is pretty. And pretty does not last as long as smart. See, you got to cash in on it when you got it. And I did. Listen, I made a very good deal. I traded my pretty years, right, for a promise from JM of a lifetime of security, and he went back on the deal. Now, when I've used up the only asset I've got.
You're a very attractive woman.
Attractive isn't shit. Especially when you've got two kids, you've got to be an absolute knockout. See, I have got dimples on my ass. It's a sign you're getting old. Men don't like women with dimples on their ass. So, I want to get a fanny tuck. I want to get a boob lift. Now, JM owes this to me. Look, the sooner I can get into a bikini, the sooner I can get another husband, the sooner JM doesn't have to support me anymore. Well, it's a lot like your law school deal, right? I mean, this is an investment that will pay off in the future. Well, that's really all I came to say. Thank you for not laughing at me. Mrs. Toombs, I'll talk to John Michael. Call me Janice.
Mr. Toombs, that young man is here to see you again. You know the one from yesterday? I'm sorry, Mr. Toombs doesn't have time to see you today.
No, I kind of didn't think he would. Do you know who I'd talk to about renting a safety deposit box?
Oh, yes, the lady on the right.
There you are, sir.
Thank you. I feel much better now.
Who is it?
The answer to a maiden's prayer.
John Michael, I can't visit right now. John Michael.
Aha. Packing?
I'm going away for the weekend.
They said you wouldn't need anything but a toothbrush. And a nightgown of your own, if you prefer. Martha may be a fine doctor, but she's a little bit of an old fogey. She's checked you into the hospital under your married name.
No.
To avoid embarrassment, I presume. They called me asking about our medical plan.
Oh, God. Well, now that you've had your big laugh, would you just go home and leave me alone?
You want me to get it?
I want you to go.
Yeah.
Amy, I have to see you. We're going to have to talk.
No, I don't think so.
Amy, look, I'm not going to just let this go. Can I see you, or do you want to meet somewhere?
Well, I can't right now.
Amy, I'm sorry. Whatever I did.
Look, I'm going away for the weekend, so maybe we can talk next week, okay? But I can't.
I'm sorry.
I have to go.
Anyone I know?
No.
The daddy.
Who is it? The father, I mean. You going to marry him? All right, I admit it. I'm jealous.
It's none of your business.
No, I have a right to know. I want to know who's been sleeping with my ex-wife.
What for? Your ego? Christ. Turn in your old car. You think nobody's ever going to drive it again?
I don't expect it to produce little cars for someone else.
John Michael, would you please go home and let me get this over with?
Oh, come on, Amy. You've got to admit it's at least ironic. All that time we tried to get you pregnant. Remember Tahiti? Taking your temperature every hour?
John Michael, I'm not in the mood for a trip down memory lane.
I'm just trying to tell you I understand. You have a career. You're free. Happy. What do you need with children? They're a pain in the ass.
I thought you were the one who always wanted them.
Well, don't get me wrong. I love my kids. Believe me, the hardest part of breaking up with Janice is Janie and Phil. But I'm looking forward to a little freedom myself. Sleeping late on the weekends. Making loud noises during sex.
Good. Then I have your approval for this abortion. It sure does take a big weight off my mind. Now, would you please go home?
I'm sorry. Came by to see if there was anything you needed. If there was anything I could do to help.
No.
Are you okay? No worse than having your tonsils out.
Oh, bullshit. A tonsil can't grow up to be president. John Michael, I'm scared to death.
You're gonna ache, but there's nothing broken.
Oh, good.
Mind telling me what you were doing?
Dr. Silver, emergency.
Growing up.
Emergency telephone, Dr. Silver.
Hasn't Amy Ash checked in, ASH?
I don't see her.
She would have checked in about an hour ago. She's early 30s, brunette, tall, very attractive.
Oh, yes. I remember. For OBGYN.
OBGYN? Do you know what room she's in?
I'm afraid she's not allowed visitors. But there's a phone right over there. Extension 340.
340. Thank you.
God, a dimple.
The doctor's ready to examine you now. To the right.
Dr. Horton, call extension 103. Dr. Horton, extension 103.
Amy?
Will, I'm afraid you're not supposed to be up here.
You want to tell me what you're doing up here?
If you don't leave immediately, I'll have to call security.
I have to talk to her. Please?
Just for a minute. The doctor's waiting.
Thanks.
It's just a routine checkup.
Amy, I was an orderly for 2 years. I know why women stay overnight in OBGYN. It's mine, isn't it?
Yeah.
Well, I don't want you to do it.
Well, it's not your choice, Will.
Amy, I told you that I don't get emotional or involved about things. Well, I lied. There are two things that I care about, you and our baby.
And the whales. Let's not forget about the whales. I'm sorry. I didn't mean that, really. I didn't. But I've thought this out, and it's for the best. I've made up my mind.
Which way is the examining room? Third door on the right.
Amy, don't do this, please. No. Please. I don't want you to do it, damn it. If you don't want to take care of them, I will.
Would you like me to accompany you downstairs?
Amy!
I'm Dr. Eastman. You're Amy?
Yeah?
I'm your doctor.
You're not my doctor. Martha Carpenter's my doctor.
You're Mrs. John M. Toombs, in for a D&C, scheduled for tomorrow morning?
Yeah.
I'm your doctor. Martha Carpenter spoke to me specially about your case.
Well, she didn't say anything to me.
I'm the pregnancy termination specialist. I handle most of her referrals.
Wait a minute.
Well, this isn't going to hurt, I promise.
No, look, you're not my doctor.
You're going to have to trust me, dear.
No, I want to speak
look,
to my...
Look, dear, I can understand you're being upset. If it were me, I'd be even more upset. Let me get you a Valium.
No!
You'll feel a lot better.
Look, I just want to talk to Martha Carpenter.
Look, dear, this is the end of a long day, and I am very tired. Now, I don't know what your arrangements with Dr. Carpenter were, but I have to go home in 10 minutes. And if we haven't been examined tonight, we're not going to be taken care of tomorrow. Now, just lie back like a good girl. Everything's going to be fine.
It'll be all right.
Down, please. Okay, just relax. Let's loosen up those stomach muscles.
Couldn't you have at least warmed that thing?
Leave the door open with a valuable mummy in the house. Dr. Silver! Dr. Silver! Tell me about this. You better look around. Now look at that room there. You search this way.
Hi. I'm Sharon.
I'm Amy.
I know. I looked on your chart. You get a D&C in the morning, and you're here early because you're an elderly prima gravida. That's someone in her 30s who's never been knocked up.
How old are you?
15. Why, how old do I look?
15 and a half. But you talk like an elderly prima gravida.
I don't know. I just like learning stuff. Hey, you met Dr. Eastman yet?
Oh, please.
He's a real nerd, you know? Totally creepy. But you don't have to worry. A D&C's easy. Well, you barf a little after, but they give you cookies and lemonade and let you watch TV. Then you go home. It's a snap.
Did they hire you as cheerleader or something?
You're funny. I like you. I'm getting a saline this time. I hear those are really gross.
You were pregnant before?
You want to hear something really dumb? Hondo, that's my old man. He said that once you had an abortion, you couldn't get pregnant again, and I believed him.
That was pretty dumb.
Well, I thought maybe he knew something I didn't.
This Hondo, you're married to him?
Well, we were going to get married, but my mother wouldn't let us. So what do you do? I mean, where do you work?
I'm a lawyer.
Far out. Oh, I always wanted to be a lawyer.
Yeah?
You make lots of money, don't you?
Some.
Boy, after I get salted out, I'm going to study real hard and get into college. And I'm going to be a lawyer. Or maybe a model. What kind of car do you drive?
An XKE.
Oh, wow.
Look, Sharon, I'm not feeling very well. I think I'm just going to go back to my room.
Oh, sure.
It's been nice meeting you, though.
Yeah, you too. Oh, and don't worry. A D&C's a snap.
Dr. Name, please call extension 508. Dr. Name, extension 508, please.
Excuse me. Could I get something to help me sleep? Of course.
¿Has sido a ese restaurante nuevo?
No, ahora.
Yo nunca fui. Dicen que la comida ya está muy suave.
Pues vamos para ahí una vez. Además, haremos que no.
Distraught, sir. Mm. Amy.
Amy.
No. Don't say anything, please. Just let me say what I came to say. I don't know why I feel so strongly about this, but I do. I want the baby, and I don't want you to have the abortion, and I'll do anything I can to get you to change your mind. Amy.
think you're going?
I have to take it downstairs and watch my call it stuck.
You make sure it gets back up here.
No problem. An hour at the most.
Hey, man, what are you doing?
I was just taking this.
Hey, sorry, man. I thought you was Julio. Have you seen Julio?
No, not tonight.
You're new, ain't you?
Yeah.
Hey, my name's Henry. Yeah. Hey, you're a lucky man, my friend. Look, I got the pool here for the series. Got a couple of choice squares left. I was saving them for that fool Julio, but hey, he's shit out of luck, all right? A dollar a square, when it picks up 100. What do you say?
No, I don't.
Oh, hey, come on, man. Everybody else is in.
I appreciate it.
Come on, just give it a look. Just look at what I got left for you.
You didn't tell me you were carting me.
I ain't standing here for my health.
No, sir. This lady's on her way to permanent outpatient status.
Yeah, really. Look, I'm going to catch your act a little bit later, okay?
And, I'll look you up. I could use $100.
Okay.
I can explain everything. We're in Santos, the old mining town on the reservation where I grew up. Remember I told you? What? You know, I told you that I really want us to have this kid. And I just want to take the time. I want to take the time and really talk about it. I want to at least have the chance to have a calm, rational discussion.
You kidnap me? You shackle me to a bed? You take me to some old ghost town and you want to have a calm, rational discussion? You are out of your mind.
I don't think so. You hungry? I went down to a vending machine. I got you some Cheez-Its and Hershey bars, trail mix. Here. Oh, and your favorite, I got you some peanut butter cups.
This is crazy.
I didn't know what else to do.
I didn't plan it.
Sorry. It's been a long night.
What am I supposed to do? Feel sorry for you?
They'll come looking for me, Will. Unlike some people I know, I go to work every day. Someone will notice when I'm missing.
All right, well, we'll write him a letter and tell him that you want some time off.
You really expect me to live here on trail mix and peanut butter cups?
I got you some milk, too. All I had was chocolate.
Morning, Mr. Toombs.
Good morning.
It's not me, Mr. Toombs.
Get me the hospital.
I've already called somebody to look into the vents.
Haven't you ever gone fishing, Roger? That smell is a dead fish.
The hospital.
Thank you. Hello, I'm calling to check on the status of Mrs. Toombs, room 340. But she can't have left. I'll be right over. I'll be back in an hour.
What about the fish?
Find it. That's what I hire a vice president for.
There's a grocery store down the road a few miles if you want me to get you some real food.
Will, you can't do this to me.
I didn't have any other choice. If I hadn't done something, I'd be too late right now. Look, you're the one that always says that I don't think about tomorrow. Well, a baby is tomorrow. As babies are tomorrow.
Will, listen to me. As your lawyer, listen to me. This is not cute and funny. This is kidnapping. And we're on Indian land. This is a federal offense. You won't even see this kid until he's 30.
I'll worry about that if it happens.
Good, good. Well, so much for thinking about tomorrow.
Look, I'm not saying that I figured everything out. I just can't let you go until I convince you.
No, her car isn't where we left it.
She certainly hasn't checked out. I have no record of her checking out.
It isn't like Amy to leave like this.
I don't know how to feel this. I was not notified of her disappearance until after checkout time.
Damn it. I should have been here.
Well, as I said, when I examined Mrs. Toombs, there was a definite ambivalence and hostility toward the medical team.
I guess she just changed her mind.
But this isn't like Amy at all.
I can understand your feelings, but that sort of thing happens all the time.
Well, she's probably just gone off somewhere to be by herself. You might as well go back to the bank, John Michael.
You sure?
I'll walk you to your car. You'll notify us if you hear anything.
She's more likely to contact one of you.
I'll let you know.
I'm not at all certain how to build this.
Well, I think I should get my full fee.
I want you to call my wife. I'm sorry, I want you to call my ex-wife every 15 minutes until someone answers.
Sure.
Where's Roger?
He said he had to fetch someone.
Now, be careful. Be careful of my baby. Don't.
Where the hell have you been?
Oh, Mr. Toombs, this is Mrs. DeVarga. Mrs. DeVarga, this is Mr. Toombs. Mr. Toombs is president of the bank. Mrs. DeVarga lives next door to my mother.
Oh, I usually feed them by now.
Hungry.
Well, it's just an idea.
They're so hungry.
Find out whose box that is. And get a court order to empty it and call the police to arrest the son of a bitch.
Thank you.
Hi. I thought I'd go for a little walk.
Will you try to understand this, Will? There are some people who just aren't cut out for motherhood. I'm one of those people.
How do you know until you've tried?
You can't just try a baby, Will. It's not like a job you can quit or even a husband. A child is always there.
That's right.
You cannot just quit a child.
Yeah, that's
right. I don't want the responsibility, do you hear me? I'm not ready for it, and I won't do it half-assed. Because if I'm a lousy mother, it's going to be a lousy kid.
Look, I told you I'd take care of the kid.
How? Come on, Will, you can't take care of a child. You can barely take care of
I don't care, I don't care. I don't want you to kill our baby.
Stop calling it a baby. It's not a baby, it's a fetus.
Oh, yeah. Oh, that's a real distinction.
The Supreme Court thinks so.
Oh, the Supreme... Is that the same Supreme Court that about 50 years ago said my people were a bunch of wild savages? Too uncivilized to have the same rights as a white man?
Will, this doesn't have anything to do with what we're talking
about. It has everything to do with what we're talking about. Let me tell you something. When I was a kid and we used to play cowboys and Indians, you know what all us good papooses always wanted to be? The cowboys. Can you blame us? I mean, cowboys always win, right? I guess I just never completely got it out of my mind that white men are Indian killers.
Is that what you think I am? Some white she-devil that's committing a genocide on your own personal little Indian? Look, Will, this is not going to be Cochise. It's barely a quarter Indian. He'll be lucky if they let him wear moccasins.
All right, forget the Indian stuff. Amy, I want this baby because it's ours. Yours and mine. It's a pretty terrific combination. And, it's a little bit of us. The good parts, if we bring them up right, that go on in the world even after we're gone. I don't know, maybe I'm crazy. I think that's important. Like pinion nuts? Climb up and get you some. Best ones are at the top, the ripe ones. I'll go on up and get you some. Want to move the sweater underneath this branch here? That's perfect, thank you. Are you thinking of running?
What good would it do? Nobody within miles.
Just the three of us.
Will!
Gotta be quick at the pinion nut business. Oh, there's a beautiful bunch up here. Yeah, there's a bunch up there. Now, Amy? Please, Amy, move the sweater underneath the branch. Thank you. Thank you.
All right, now. Look out below. It's going to be hail and pinion nuts.
Did I get you?
Amy?
Amy! Amy, come back here! Amy, come back here! Stop! Amy!
okay?
Oh, I'm going to hurt the baby. You would have jumped.
Well.
Please, Amy. Please. I love you, and I don't want to hurt you, but I can't let you do that. Can't you see?
I just want to talk to you.
Damn it, Will. I don't want to play games with you.
I'm coming up, Will, okay?
Ah.
Howdy, Will. I'm going to have to ask you to come along with us.
Charged with offense against public code 182.7, malicious mischief. PC 197.45A, assault by stink bomb or other noxious element. Municipal Code 9.3, creating a hazard to the public health. MC 21.1, creating a situation likely to disturb the public, plus breaking and entering by means of instrumentality.
Instrumentality? To wit, one pizza. Go ahead and smirk, jackass. That could be a federal rap. It's up to the U.S. attorney. Read him as Miranda.
You have the right to remain silent. Anything you say can and will be used against you in a court of law. You have the right to have an attorney present before questioning. If you cannot afford an attorney, one will be appointed for you free of charge. Understanding your rights, do you wish to waive them and talk to us at this time?
This is all rinky-dink.
Not when you screw around with banks. Oh, they get real upset when you screw around with a bank. Are you waiving your rights to a lawyer?
No.
Call the broad.
Oh, wait, hold. Just a minute. Don't I get bail or something?
Not without a lawyer.
Well, Amy is out of town.
Call the public defender. Get the new guy.
Most of the charges are unconstitutionally vague and deny due process. I think we can also make a case for unequal enforcement.
You know, it'll be very interesting to see the last time it was applied to an angle.
How soon can you get me bail?
That won't be set until your arraignment. That's not until Tuesday.
Tuesday? It's going to have to be sooner than that.
Well, something I have to tell you. You know, you're my first Native American. I consider you a sacred trust.
I appreciate that. How soon can you get me out of here?
I told you Tuesday.
Can't go without food and water till Tuesday.
A hunger strike? Do you think that's necessary?
It's up to you. I'll tell you one thing. You sure focused a lot of attention on your case.
Mr. Green.
Call me Monroe.
Monroe, I know you mean well.
Thank you.
Oh, hiya, Phil. Hi.
Did you go to Stella? Marcy's father stole her. Mommy, Mommy, Mommy! Mommy, hit the yell and scream if you can. Mommy!
I'm not going to steal you, I promise you.
You're not?
No.
Don't you like us anymore? Mommy, Daddy's here, but he's not going to steal us like Marcy's father.
No, honey, I guess not. You two go on back to bed.
Kiss me goodnight first. Mwah. I'll see you on the weekend, all right?
Yeah.
Okay, be good. You didn't have to tell them I was going to steal them.
I was angry. I was upset. You didn't have to sneak in to get your stupid bonsai. Huh. I met your ex-wife yesterday.
She told me.
She's very attractive.
Mm-hmm.
When this is all over, maybe you two should get back together. Oh, my God. Oh, I just hit the jackpot, you son of a bitch. You really are perverted, you know that?
This is ridiculous.
I mean, you don't have the decency to run off with an 18-year-old. Oh, no, that would be too normal. You have got to go off with an older woman.
Janice, I don't know what I'm doing.
Well, I do. You are making a fool out of me.
You're doing fine by yourself.
Damn you, Jam. I hate you, you bastard.
Will you put the gun down, Janice?
I want that surgery, J.M. I deserve that surgery.
Have the surgery. I'm not stopping you. Just put down the gun.
I need $4,000. Now. Oh, you have to give me the money, J.M. You owe it to me.
You quit waving that thing around.
Don't you dare turn your back on me.
You're not going to shoot me, and you know it.
Oh, you. You're goddamn.
Oh, my God!
I hate them.
You shot my Zolkova Serrata. Don't do it! That plan is 350 years old.
And I'm going to be 30. I want a both left. I need that fanny top.
You need is a psychiatrist, please. Don't shoot my bonsai.
How much is it worth to you? I want $4,000 tomorrow, or I am going to execute every goddamn plan in the house.
No, no!
I'll do it. You know I'll do it.
All right, have the surgery. Just give me my bonsai.
Mommy, you gonna shoot Daddy like Marcy's mommy did?
No, darling. I'm just holding his little trees hostage. When Dr. Levine gets his money, your daddy gets his lousy bonsai back.
Come on, Will. Can't expect the public defender to keep sending lawyers down here for you to audition. It's a damn Sunday morning.
I want you to get Amy.
Well, you know how to reach her?
Oh, she's in Santos, the old ghost town. Handcuffed to a bed.
What the hell did you say?
Why didn't you call me? Where's Amy? Well, what are we waiting for?
Well, that's reservation land. We don't have jurisdiction. Federal boys will be here in a bit.
I'm going to get my wife.
These people are pretty particular about who comes in their land. I don't want any confrontation.
You can't stop me, Chief. What the hell do you think you're doing?
Protecting the peace.
You're going to pay for that tire. And I'm still going for my wife.
You're under arrest, Mr. Toombs.
Ah, come off it. You can't arrest me. I'm not some goddamn minority. I'm the president of the bank, for God's sake.
I'm getting real tired of this whole business. Read him his rights and take him in.
Mr. Toombs!
You have the right to remain silent!
Mr. Toombs!
We have the right to have an attorney closing before questioning anything you...
Brunette, 5'7", early 30s, color of eyes, can't tell, hazel.
Don't worry, ma'am, we're FBI.
have to be an examination.
You can have your same room.
If there's a single mark on her, I want to know about it.
Look, I'm all right. Really.
I want you under observation for today, just a precaution.
As long as I can take a bath, I'll kill for a bath.
Miss Aisha, I want you to know you're perfectly safe now. We have the kidnapper behind bars. Now, I'm personally going to see to it that no turkey lawyer gets him off on some technicality.
Thank you, gentlemen. I believe I can handle it from here.
Yes, ma'am. May I help you?
Oh, hello. I'm Mrs. Toombs. I'm here for some cosmetic surgery. Dr. Levine arranged the room.
Just a minute, ma'am. Let me check on that, please.
Hey, buddy.
What you in for? Overdressing?
Is this really necessary?
I'm sorry. Everybody goes in the holding tank.
You. You're the cause of all this. I'm going to see they put you away for life.
I never did a damn thing to you except stink up your damn bank when you wouldn't give me...
You stepped up his bank!
Hey, boys, we got us a bank robber in here!
A bank robber! Rich bastard, they got you in here. You don't have a hair on your ass and you don't match his face in.
Look, I'm sorry about your damn bank, all right?
To hell with the bank. I'm talking about Amy.
What about Amy?
You're the bastard, got her pregnant.
Well, what the hell has that got to do with you?
She's my wife.
You knocked up his old lady? Hey, fellas, the proper knocked up the banker's old lady, too.
Hey, look, I didn't know.
Oh, you didn't know.
He got your woman pregnant
and then he kidnapped her.
The bitch ran away with him, too.
I thought I was a heavy dude, man. You're something else, man.
Come on, get out.
Hey, listen, you ain't got one hair on your ass. If you don't rip his head off, listen.
Get it. Go for it. Get it all the way.
Toombs, the chief isn't going to press charges. You're free to go.
What is this? Oh, hey,
you ain't got a hair on your ass. Not one hair.
I can't have that much in commodities. I'm sorry, Don. I'll have to call you back.
Aha! We were worried you'd gone off again.
The nurse said you wanted to see me?
Yes. There's one small problem. It seems the hospital spoke with your insurance people over the mix-up of the last few days and all, and your health plan doesn't cover a VIP, a voluntarily interrupted pregnancy.
Oh.
So I'm afraid the hospital's going to have to ask for partial payment in advance. Now, there is an alternative, however. It's just a suggestion. But if we were to perform a tubal ligation, a DNC would be a routine adjunct.
That's tying my tubes?
The fallopian tubes, that's correct. I'd really like to get in there and clean house.
So I couldn't conceive again?
Well, yes. You see, we'd make the incision in the navel. The scar would be absolutely invisible. It's really a marvelous procedure. And it's covered by your insurance. Your whole stay would be taken care of.
But I could never get pregnant again.
Well, with your medical history, there isn't any real chance that's going to happen again anyway. So the operation wouldn't be doing anything to you that Mother Nature hasn't already. After all, you are an elderly prima gravida.
The next time that anybody calls me that, they're not going to get to be an elderly anything.
Now, I can understand you're being upset, dear.
Hell yes, I'm upset, dear. This is my body that you're being so cavalier about.
Maybe I should get you a Valium.
Get out of my room.
Now, this just
seems... Get out of my room! Get out of my room!
Thank you.
aren't you late to get this back?
We broke a car ring this afternoon. Your truck's in pretty good shape. We even got your piano back for you.
Thanks a lot.
Nothing to worry about. We'll take good care of it from now on. You know, make sure no one steals it again. You can have it all back as soon as you get out.
20 years.
Yeah, with good behavior.
You're a hell of a comfort, Binky.
You mind a visitor? Oh. He's just arrived, and I said I'd bring him up.
Thanks.
There's a card.
John Michael.
I figured. Eastman called me with his brilliant idea. You want me to get you another doctor?
You won't do it? You think it's wrong?
No, it is not wrong. I performed abortions, plenty of them, and I did it when it was illegal. And I was the only chance some poor woman had. I could have gone to prison. I believed in it then. I believe in it now. I just let others do it. I prefer not to anymore.
Why? Can you tell me, please?
Well, I don't know. It happens to lots of doctors. Intellectually, you know it's all right. It would be for the best. It's a tragedy for many of these fetuses to come to term if you just decide to let somebody else do it instead.
Well, it'd be all wrong for me to have a baby now. It's
death and taxes and children. It's never a convenient time for any of them.
You think I should have it?
I didn't say that.
No, but you would. You'd have it?
If I had had a baby, I wouldn't have gotten where I am now. I will be here in the morning when you come out from under.
Martha. Thank you.
Oh.
Hello?
Don't hang up, please.
I think I'm calling my lawyer.
Will, I won't let you make me feel guilty.
No, I just want to tell you something.
Maybe, I don't know, what you said is true. This isn't a decision that you can just force on somebody. And I'm not going to believe that you're some terrible, evil person if you... I mean, I can't hate you if you have the abortion. I can't dictate your life. I have enough trouble with my own... Just wanted our baby. Bye.
And
I'll send it on to you. And when I make my wish on a falling star, I will wait to be right where you are. And I love you now as I loved you then, and tomorrow I will love you still.
Would you check on Mrs. Toombs? She's not in room 340. That's right, Mrs. J.M. Toombs, in for a D&C. Thanks, I appreciate it. She's on the second floor. Mrs. Toombs?
Yes?
They're ready for your procedure now.
Oh, already? Do you know what occurred to me last night? I am bored with worrying about me. The times I've been happiest in my life was when I was so concerned with something or someone else that I just forgot about myself for a while. Like when you and I were married, or with Will, or even some of my clients. When I'm involved in something that I see as, I don't know, more, bigger than just me, that's when I'm most content. And I thought I was somebody who was afraid of responsibility. But it's responsibility that makes me feel like somebody. And I thought I'd start small. With one little baby.
Look, I'm not saying I object to another child. It's just that I'm not crazy about it being somebody else's.
You don't really want to marry me again.
What do you think all this has been about? I thought you were happy to see me.
I am. John Michael, really, I am. I've been bitter about you for years, and it was stupid.
So what you're really saying is you want this musician, right?
No. What I'm saying is I really want this baby. Look. The courthouse is just a couple of blocks. I can walk.
It's okay. I'll take you.
Anytime.
Good morning.
She's ready, doctor.
Good.
Who is this?
This is Mrs. Toombs.
This is not Mrs. Toombs. Think I don't know my own patients?
Will the representative of the people read the charges against the defendant?
It is alleged that on or about 20 September instant, the defendant did willfully, wrongfully, and feloniously abduct one Amy Ash, a female human being. You can't come in court in session.
I'm counsel for the defendant, Thorson.
Do you have a card?
Excuse me. What's going on, bailiff?
She has a card, Your Honor.
Thank you. Will you please step forward and state your name for the record?
Amy Ash, Your Honor. Counsel for the defendant, William Thorson.
A little horse.
The defendant is already represented. Is the defendant requesting a change of counsel at this time?
Hell yes. Sir.
Will new counsel advise the defendant against any further outburst?
Yes, Your Honor. Thank you.
Excuse me, counsel. Are you in relation to the alleged victim, Amy Ash, named in the complaint?
Yes, Your Honor. We're one and the same.
Let me get this straight. He's charged with kidnapping you, and now you're defending him?
Well, it's a little odd, I admit.
Odd, irregular, and improper. Do you plan to cross-examine yourself, Miss Ash?
Well, isn't that preferable to denying the accused counsel of his choice?
Don't lecture me, young lady.
Look, Your Honor, this is really very simple. I'm just not going to testify against Will, so the prosecution has no case.
Your Honor, I object.
You're perilously close to a contempt citation, Miss Ashe. This is a crime against the people. You do not have the option of refusing to testify. Should you so refuse, you'll be held in contempt of court.
Your Honor, could we stop being so formal and just go into your chambers and work this thing out? It's really no big deal.
No big deal. They only found you handcuffed to a bed.
Danny.
She was what?
Handcuffed to a bed. In an abandoned house.
Damn it, Danny. Shut up.
That's it. That's contempt. Please note for the record that counsel for the accused is held in contempt. Sentencing to be held immediately following this arraignment.
Your Honor, please. Could we just go into your chambers?
Counsels will return to their respective tables. Your motion is denied, Miss Ash. Any motion for dismissal of this case will be heard in open court. Now, keeping in mind my dwindling patience, do you have a motion, Miss Ash?
Your Honor, my motion is to dismiss the charge. There was no kidnapping. The defendant had my full consent.
That's ridiculous.
Young lady, you have already acquired one contempt citation. Are you trying for perjury as well?
No, Your Honor, I'm trying to be candid, but it's terribly embarrassing in an open courtroom.
Your Honor, I have some FBI photographs here.
The prosecutor will be seated. I will note your discomfort for the record, but we will continue as we are. Now, how about the handcuffs, Miss Ash? You were handcuffed.
Your Honor, have you ever read The Joy of Sex?
The what?
The Joy of Sex.
The Joy of Sex.
The Joy of Sex. Because I plan to introduce what you might call the joy of sex defense.
Second thought, perhaps we should continue this in my chambers. Court is in recess until 11 o'clock a.m.
You're not married, are you?
Divorced.
And you really think my fanny is okay the way it is?
Take it from an expert.
Are you free for dinner tonight?
Yes.
Well, we'll do okay. You'll see. Maybe after this is all over, we could... get married?
I can't marry you, Will. I probably love you, too, but I can't marry you. I'm going to have enough trouble with the baby. I can't take care of you both.
Well, he's my kid, too.
Well, you'll see her. I want you to see her. There's a lot you can offer her.
Well, you won't marry me?
We'll talk about it after the release, okay?
When's that going to be?
I know. I think probably sometime tomorrow.
Okay, well, I'll be here.
Miss Ash, you'll have to come with me now.
Thanks for coming to see me.
Sure.
What's that, a law book?
Yes, night school. I figured I could still play music during the day.
Little horse rides again.
Amy, I won't give up. I'll ask you again.
Good.
You'll change your mind.
Good.
You took me by surprise. You came like a thunderstorm in July. And I was all packed for leaving when you filled my sky. But you set me on my feet and gave me the confidence I need. Prepared the soil and supplied the seed. And now there's a full moon, all golden and low, shining through all the bedroom window. And your voice goes all silky and slow, saying what we already know. You gave it back to me. In this world where nothing goes free, I call that love, you call that honesty. Now there's a full moon, all golden and low, shining through a bedroom window. Woo, woo, woo. And your voice goes all silky and slow, saying what we already know. I call that love, you call that honesty. And now there's a full moon, all golden and low, shining through our bedroom window. And your voice goes all silky and slow, saying what we already know. Saying what we already know.